schoolgirls have so far been arrested in connection with the Omobera Girls School arson incident that occurred 3 days ago. According to the Kisii County Commissioner, Kula Hache, police are searching for three others from Itierio Secondary School, still in the county of Kisii, in connection with the burning of 7 dormitories. Fred Moturi has been following that for us.
As the fire incidents increase in Kisii region, education stakeholders have called for an end to what they called public relations gimmicks so that the root cause of the recurring fire incidents in secondary schools cannot be found.
This is a menace, and if we have to go to the deep root of the problem, is to set up an investigating committee to find out the real causes of these fires.
If it is the principals who are doing it, because maybe they want to cover up a few of the heinous activities, then indeed the investigations have to be thorough, and then reports have to be made available for the public to know.
The officials say that they support the new measures being put up by the Ministry of Education, but they maintained that the law on safety in schools was not being enforced.
Right now, while investigations are being done, the magnitude of destruction that we are seeing, especially at Itierio Boys, we want to believe very strongly that students themselves on their own don't have the capacity to do that. We are seeing also another hand of some other arsonists from out there who may be aiding the students to destroy this particular kind of facilities that we have.
One of the major safety measures we found to be ignored by a number of schools is that boarding schools' dormitories were not at least 5 feet wide and are not opened outwards. Most of the dormitories have no emergency exits at the middle and back, and windows have metal grills, compromising on the safety of students in case of a fire incident.
How come that these electric faults are very selective? How come that they only select the dormitories? And how come that they only take place in the nights?
Joyce Mogeni, who has a child in Nyamache High School, said that she was forced to buy her son fresh supplies when the school was again affected by the fire tragedy late last month.
Sai niko na shida maana shule iliungua mara ya kwanza, vitu vikaungua yote, ni kanunua tena leo imeungua. Sasa ni shida kwa mimi kama msasi, ni pia nifumana school fees inatoa tena naanza kununua vitu, mtoto ana chochote, ana hata kiatu.
Firefighters have a serious challenge in accessing most schools in Kisii due to the manner in which they are constructed.
So it's indeed a disaster in waiting if, for example, there is no accessibility onto the buildings.
Parents in Kisii are left wondering why the Office of the County Quality Assurance and Standards has failed to crack the whip on some of the schools that seem to have ignored the basic safety guidelines. Following these recurring fire incidences in schools, the government has been asked to take all safety precautions at hand and make sure all suspects are arrested, and at the same time implement the safety regulations in schools. Fred Moturi, KTN News in Nyamache, Kisii.